Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on how to measure vacuum pressure by using simple YouTube manometer. So for that I have a question here. A simple YouTube manometer containing mercury is connected to a pipe in which a fluid of specific gravity 0.8 and having vacuum pressure is flowing. Full stop. The other end of the manometer is open to atmosphere. Find the vacuum pressure in the pipe if the difference of mercury level in the two limbs is 40 cm and the height of fluid in the left from the center of the pipe is 15 cm below. So this is the question. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data, and for that purpose I have drawn the diagram here. This diagram indicates YouTube manometer for vacuum pressure measurement. I'll read the question and write the data for this. In the data, here the question is, a simple YouTube manometer containing mercury is connected to a pipe in which fluid of specific gravity 0.8 and having vacuum pressure is flowing. So the specific gravity of the fluid, I'll denote it by S1, it is equal to 0.8 and it is flowing inside this pipeline, and here the heavier liquid is mercury. So in black, which I am showing here, this is mercury. Next, the other end of the manometer is open to atmosphere. Here I have kept this end, it is open to atmosphere. Find the vacuum pressure in the pipe. So I have to find out how much is the pressure inside this pipeline. I'll denote that pressure as P. That is pressure inside the pipe. If the difference of mercury level in the two limbs is 40 cm. So the difference of mercury level, here I have this portion is called as left limb and this is the right limb. So the mercury level, if I measure from this surface, that is 40 cm is the level difference. Next, and the height of the fluid in the left from the center of the pipe is 15 cm below. So from this center of the pipe, the fluid is 15 cm below. So now this much is the data which we have. And let us try to get the solution for this problem. In the solution part, I'll say that since balancing both the sides of YouTube manometer when I'm balancing this, I'll start from this pipeline. Inside that, here we have a pressure P. At the same time, we have this fluid column of 15 cm height. So its pressure will be rho G into H. For the fluid inside the pipe, I'll write suffix 1. At the same time, in the left portion, we even have mercury of 40 cm height. So its pressure will also be added. So plus rho G into H. For mercury, I'll write suffix 2. Now this much is the total pressure in the left limb. In the right limb, there is no, we can say, fluid above the datum, above this horizontal line. So that is equal to 0. So this is the balancing of both the limbs of the YouTube manometer. Now, since we want to calculate the value of pressure P, I'll say that therefore P will be equal to, I'll send these terms onto the other side. So it is minus rho 1 G into H1 minus rho 2 G into H2. So I'll be putting the values one by one. Minus rho 1 is the density of the fluid inside the pipe. Since its specific gravity is given, so from that I can calculate the density. That will be specific gravity into the density of standard fluid, which is water. So therefore the density rho 1 is equal to 0.8 into density of water is 1000, So I'm getting rho 1 value as 800 kg per meter cube. So here I'll put the values. It is 800 into g is 9.81 into h1. Here this height of fluid we can take it as h1. So h1 is 15 centimeter. It is 15. Next, minus rho 2, the density of mercury is 13,600 into 9.81, and the height of mercury is h2, that is the level difference. I'll write here h1 was 15 centimeter, h2 level difference of mercury 40 centimeter. So here I have put all the values. From this, if I calculate, my answer will be, first of all, it will be negative, and the value is 5.45 Newton per centimeter square. If I want to convert it in terms of meter square, I'll have to multiply it by 10 raised to 4. So that becomes minus 5.45 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per meter square. So here, as we can see, our answer is negative. And if the answer is negative, it means that the pressure inside the pipeline is vacuum pressure. So here in this video, we have seen how to calculate vacuum pressure by using simple YouTube manometer.